Hi, welcome to the award-winning Ed Brown Show. And we have our top correspondents here with, I know you haven't seen her for a while, but I gave her a few days off, Edwanda Larkin. And guess what? We're back with the Bay Sox. And we have a gentleman here, Matt McLaughlin. He's been out there beating the bushes for a long time, 10 years. He's in charge of the guys that all the boards you see out there, the Coke sign and all that stuff. He's got it, brings that in. So we're going to ask him a few questions. And basically, what has he been doing all these 10 years? Welcome, Matt, to the Ed Brown Show.
Thank you for having me on. Very excited.
Good. Tell us a little bit about yourself. I told you I was going to have a question that you weren't expecting that. we want to know about you. How did you get involved? Go ahead. Tell us about it.
Well, I got involved out of college. Went to college, got my sport management degree, and knew I wanted to work in baseball. And basically, as that started to happen, I just found internships. And the Bay Sox were one of them. I'm from the area, so it was very helpful in that aspect. And from there, worked very hard, and they offered me a ticket sales position. And the ticket sales position, again, I just worked very hard. It's always kind of my calling card, and was able to kind of slowly move up that ladder in terms of lines of business. And lines of business from there, transitioned into sponsorship sales, and then some changes within the office occurred, and ultimately, they kind of, about 5 years ago, moved me into the director of sponsorships position, and been there ever since. And it's been a fun ride reaching that overall position as I currently am in right now. But beauty is I'm involved in a lot of other aspects too.
Yeah, like
so your work ethic paid off.
Absolutely.
Every time I'm at the Bay Sox Arena, Matt is always running around working, doing this and doing that. But there have been some new installations at the Bay Sox Arena. Can you tell us about those?
Oh, yes. We've actually installed a new video board in our left field wall. It's still a little bit of work in progress, but it's going to be a great finish. The ultimate goal is to have it basically cut up into three parts. And then so you'll have the main middle will be, you know, where the batter's headshots are and their names, and then we're going to hopefully have stats and another ultimate piece of signage that goes into that spot. And that used to be the scoreboard, that scoreboard is now going to be a digital scoreboard in right field.
Oh, wow.
So, and we're very excited about that. So during the inning breaks, we can have a dueling video board going on. So that's a very, very unique opportunity there.
That is so neat. Getting to this Sunday, Mr. Brown, I'm going to tell you now, Happy Father's Day.
Right.
And I don't know if Matt is, no. Not Happy Father's Day to him. But you guys are having something special there for Father's Day this Sunday. Could you tell us about it?
Absolutely. We will be having a Father's Day brunch upstairs in our luxury level, as well as a father and son.
Everybody's invited, just father.
It's a special ticket package that you have to go through to the organization to get. It is a catered event, so a lot like our Mother's Day brunch that we've had in the past. And basically, we're also going to have a father-son catch on the field, a lot similar to how we did the Mother's Day events. And again, the father should be able to run the bases with their children like they did. Not just father-son, father-children catch on the field. Let me correct that. And then the fathers should be able to run the bases as well after the game with their children.
Okay. Good. What seems to be your most sold out event there at the Bay Sox Arena? I know on Monday nights it's dedicated to dogs. Monday nights is Mutt Night. And then you have Dollar Day Nights and the fireworks and Parents Night Out. You have so many things going on there.
I'm actually glad you asked that question. Mm-hmm. It's been growing every year, and hopefully not reach its pinnacle, but getting close to it. Our Star Wars night this Saturday is going to have a great crowd.
Oh, wow.
You know, we're going to have legions and battalions from Star Wars regiments, actors, basically, costumes.
Okay, Queen Leia. Yeah.
Princess Leia.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Well, hopefully, we'll definitely we'll have stormtroopers there. We're gonna have Ewoks. We're gonna have hopefully Darth Vader there. Superhero Night's a little further down the season. I think in July, but Star Wars Night, they're gonna have some lightsaber battles. So it's gonna be a pretty unique opportunity. And what we've learned is, especially because of the cartoon now, that Star Wars has really, it's not just the 30, 40 and on age group because of the 1970s and 80s movies, mm-hmm. but because of the cartoon, it's really reached a lot of young generation too. And I think that's what makes the day so much fun to be involved with now.
Wow. Because it's generational, mm-hmm. Not this jet generation, but this generation.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Oh, and Sunday, I wanted to add, I didn't get a chance to.
Okay, sure.
Sunday is actually going to be our Meet the Team Day, so our players will be up on the concourse signing autographs from about 1 o'clock to 1:40-ish. They'll be up there signing autographs for the fans.
Oh, that's so neat.
Speaking of signing autographs, the other night there, you had a comedian on there. And people were elated about it, but I didn't even know the joke.
yesterday, yes. This came together very quickly.
Yeah.
And we were very, very happy to have it, but Gabriel Fluffy Iglesias. He's a very popular comedian right now. He was in Magic Mike. Not one of the dancers, as he says, but he was I believe he was a bartender character in that movie. And so he has a movie coming out in July 11th called The Fluffy Movie. And so he's in D.C. to promote it, and they called us up, and we were absolutely ecstatic to have him out there.
Oh, wow.
He's a very down, what you see on TV is exactly who he is. He was an awesome guy to meet yesterday.
Great. Okay, well, tell us something about that. You going out, you got a pretty tough position, getting people to come in and spend their money, on the different advertising.
It is. It is a unique and difficult position, but a rewarding one. It's really about picking up the phone and calling businesses, and reaching out to them, even going to networking events and really just introducing yourself, who you are, who you work for, and creating relationships. And that's the key there, is you got to create relationships.
So you don't have any price level for nonprofit organizations.
We have opportunities there, for nonprofit organizations. A lot of times we can find a way to make it work through a fundraiser or setting up a table on the concourse, which we've learned, over the last few years, that's really become an ideal way for any business, nonprofit or profit, to really make the connection with the fan. They're talking mano a mano, right to the person. And,
but the greatest one is the reading program.
Oh, it's
now tell us a little bit about that.
It's one of the feathers in our caps. It really is. It's a program we've had going on for years now. We've actually had to split it up into three county sections, basically.
Right.
Yeah,
this is a whole metropolitan area.
Oh, pretty much. Yeah, we have. We have the Anne Arundel Reading Night. That also includes Howard County, Queen Anne County. And that's really been kind of the one that sets the tone. It's been great to have them involved. Mm-hmm. We have Prince George's Montgomery County, and that involves a little bit of D.C. as well. And then we have Southern Maryland, Charles County, Calvert County, and St. Mary's County. And mm-hmm. so we've, it's a great way to get this involved in the schools. Send Louie down there, send a few of the staff down there. What we do actually to kind of help promote the reading program is we have a coloring contest, a poster contest in early in the off season, right before Christmas, and then we'll pick that winner, and then we will go to the school of the winner.
Is that right?
And what we used to do is have one winner per the weekend. Mm-hmm. We actually, this year, with the help of our sponsor, Educational Systems Federal Credit Union, we now have a winner from each county involved. So we've enhanced that aspect to it, and really it's been great. So we'll go to the school, and we'll surprise the winner. They have no clue it's happening. They're usually told it's a rally for the school, and we surprise them. And we'll have some of our staff members there, and again, as I said, Louie.
And the students just love Louie. They just love Louie.
How effective?
Of course, it's very effective.
Very, Very effective. It's
that's education. We want our students, we want our children to read. Mm-hmm. Reading is fundamental. It's is essential.
You need
so that
everything.
Is an excellent,
absolutely.
Excellent program that they have there at the base.
So the premise of it is basically from mid-January until early March, we want the students to read four books. And if they read four books, they sign off on the poster. And then the teacher, the reading coordinators at the school will contact us and say, you know, we need, and basically when you read four books, that student gets a free ticket to the games that we have set up for the weekend.
Who selects the book?
It's the students, you know. It's,
the
teachers
the
might have
the
a, the students select the books, the teachers probably have a criteria to, you know, you can't read a magazine, but you can read a book, so.
A novel.
You can't read a novel, a magazine.
I'm sure the teachers set up different criteria. It's going to be based on the class levels, and but you read four books, you get a free ticket, and then we set up a ticket option discount for the parents, because we know they got to bring the kids to the game, and that really was what helps the crowd that night. Fireworks as well.
Excellent.
Right. Hey, don't forget the fireworks now, because you know a lot of kids. That's I see them in the stand there, and they be just playing everything. Time for the fireworks, they paying
ready.
Attention to
yeah.
everything. You know, tell us a little bit about the team itself. You know, they have AAA, AA. What is that?
Well, the AA, it's really about progression. You know, if you talk about the majors, it's about win and loss, wins and loses and losses, and really trying to win the championship. But for the minors, it's really about progression. Are you progressing towards where they want, which is hopefully to make the majors? And you know, so it's not necessarily about the win-loss record down in AA. And what you see is a lot of the top end talent now comes through AA. And then might head up to the major leagues, to the Baltimores of the world, to the Washingtons, New Yorks of the world. And really what you're seeing is a lot of the AAA still gets a good portion of talent, but they're also getting a lot of depth talent, basically, for the majors in case a major league player gets hurt or they need another pitcher.
Yeah, well, that's it. The fans are accustomed to who a player, and they look up the next game. If the Orioles or Yankees, whatever team they name, he's gone.
He might be gone, absolutely.
Yeah, right.
And what you're seeing now is that a lot of hitters, especially the top end hitters, are coming straight from AA to the majors, and a lot of that is, in maybe more of my opinion, is that the pitching is pretty similar, for the most part, with AAA and the major leagues, especially for kind of the back half of the rotations up there. There are very few Justin Verlanders, Felix Hernandez, ace pitchers of the world.
Right. Well, that's what I was saying. Generally, I observe that one of the most wanted position is left-handed pitchers. What do you think?
Oh, absolutely. It's
so all of you out there, kid left-handed, he might make the majors.
Exactly. It's you know, especially your left-handed relievers, because they can really go at the left-handed hitters and hopefully, you know, cancel them out. So
left-handed pitcher he throws that ball and he hits the knuckleball, you know, and then he's able to me it's just tough. Just my observation. So all you youngsters out there, as far as left-handed boys,
keep trying. Yeah,
being realistic, sometimes it's majority of the players, they have other jobs, off-season, things like that, because the pay is not on the level with the majors.
Yeah, it's different. It's you know, you only get paid while you're playing. So when the season's over. And you're not involved, need to go find a supplemental job. And you see a lot of guys that are finding off-season jobs, obviously, because they have families and they need to take care of their families and all that. And you do get a few of the high draft picks that are they're more or less playing year-round, maybe taking off a month and a half right before spring training. But you know, a lot of the certain players are going to go to fall ball in the Arizona Fall League, or some might go down
some
to the Dominican Republic.
What about overseas? And some of them play overseas.
There's an Australian league too.
Okay.
Australian summer league, winter league for us, but that some might go play. But it's really up to some players go do that on their own. mm-hmm. and other players are.
Well, you know. they're not on the contract.
No,
but during the time they're not playing, they don't have to get the parent permission to pay.
Well, you know, I can't really answer that question.
No,
I don't know the whole ins and outs of the contracts, mm-hmm. and obviously if. If you get hurt and you're not under not under the major league team's watch, you know.
Yeah, with an injury, that's in all sports.
Yeah, you know, that could be
unless you have it in your contract. Yeah.
Yeah, but if you get hurt on the field, you know, then the team's gonna is watching
take
that basically.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly, take mm-hmm. care of you.
Mm-hmm. Well, what do you have for the future out there?
All right, great question. We actually have Christian Walker, our first baseman, who's just tearing the ball apart out there, mm-hmm. and. You know, he's a very hard guy to get out right now.
Wow.
Our center fielder, Dariel Ramirez, he's doing really great as well. Another guy that's very hard to get, basically getting out right now. Those two guys are doing pretty well. You know, it's up to the Orioles how they use them. But
wow.
those two are probably the ones to watch right now coming through the system. The catcher, Michael Ullman, he's he's one to watch as well. He's starting to come around with his average this year. So
the scouts, Matt, are at every game?
Pretty much. Oh, mm-hmm. yeah. You'll see mm-hmm. scouts from the beginning of the year until the trade deadlines.
Wow.
You know, okay. and then the scouts might not be around after mm-hmm. that. But, mm-hmm. yeah, there you see a lot of scouts coming in throughout the season until maybe late August. Mm-hmm. And then it kind of disappears from there.
Well, tell me this. As far as the community concerned, do you get involved in – allowing the always against the rules of the league, allowing local teams to play at the stadium
on the field. That you know, we're on Maryland National Capitol Park planning land, so
right.
Mm. So we have a relationship with them. We work with them, and we do have the Cal Ripken League, Senior League, and high school leagues do play games there.
Mm-hmm.
We actually have a program. Set up by our promotions manager, Chris Rogers, who he actually sets up a games pretty much after every Sunday day game. Two teams will play against each other.
A lot of people don't realize
that
they can get involved in a league there.
Yeah, it's a lot of it's set up through us, but our schedule kind of dictates what's available.
Well, that's what I'm saying. How do they work them in, you know, with your schedule?
Well, the ones we do on Sunday, you know, is a specific ticket package
mm-hmm.
because we know we have a game,
mm-hmm.
So they're kind of based on when our game finishes.
Well, that's good, but a lot of people don't realize that's available. Mm-hmm. You know,
that's just like any sales job. You got to go out and.
Yeah.
Contact commissioners
right.
and tell them, hey, here's an opportunity to get involved and play, but here's what you got to, here are the criteria for it.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have other ones, you know, like I said, the high school leagues, maybe playoffs.
Well, the high school leagues play there also?
Maybe playoffs, more or less. But
they
We have a lot of games, you know, youth league games that are played there. It's a great chance. You're playing on a professional field.
I know, but you know, very seldom people get a chance. They don't realize that.
Yeah.
They don't do much advertising on that.
Yeah.
You know, the involvement of the community teams.
Well, does it have something to do with, I know you have to maintain your field.
Yeah, there's,
so maintenance is
there's a lot of maintenance that goes into that
mm-hmm.
baseball field.
Mm-hmm.
It's, you know, you got to keep that grass cut at a certain level, mm-hmm. certain inch.
You got to take
care of the infield specifically. Mm-hmm. You know, the dirt is, it's a lot of factors that go into that I will never understand.
Mm-hmm.
But it's important.
The public, I think most of them, I didn't know that other teams in the county participated in a program there.
Mm-hmm. Yes. It's set up
Is it set up through park and planning? Or
a little bit of both.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, they need to check with us to make sure something's not planned.
That is available, but they can actually utilize the field for the mm-hmm. Little League.
Maybe not Little, like Cal Ripken League, kind of the traveling leagues,
mm-hmm.
a little bit more in terms of advanced than the Little, like 10 and under.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's 10. Oh, that's
no,
the
no.
Age,
it's
right.
it's over. Yeah,
it's over 10.
It's like high school level, basically.
Mm-hmm. I see.
So,
yeah. Well, that makes a difference.
It does.
You don't have to worry about parental approval and all of that.
Exactly.
Yeah. Liability too.
Yeah. Matt, Independence Day is coming up
mm-hmm.
next month. What do you guys have planned?
July 3rd, we're having our Independence Red, White, and Boom celebration, and that's our July 3rd, July 4th game. It's going to have fireworks, a great involvement. It's going to be sponsored by TD Bank in North America, and specifically the branch over here in Bowie. Mm-hmm. And then on July 4th, we are going to be hosting the Bowie celebration. Again, that should probably have a concert throughout the day, put together by Bowie, and there'll be fireworks a little bit after 9, obviously, when the sun sets. We did that last year, and it was a great event. Everybody from Bowie wanted to check it out, and mm-hmm. we're excited to host that again.
Oh, good.
So. Now, you find there's a lot of orange jerseys running around there, and some people wonder, what are they doing? They're doing different jobs. Now, if a youngster want to get involved with employment during the summer, what's the procedure for that?
All right, well, there's a couple different routes. The orange jerseys, the one you're specifically talking about, is our Orange Ambassadors Program, and that's the collegiate internships, seasonal internships.
Internship.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Oh.
And what that involves is what you're seeing specifically at that point during a game is they're helping out with our promotions. Mm-hmm. So they're the ones running the in-between inning games, mm-hmm. The dizzy bat races, the
dollar run.
The dollar runs, yeah, the old line bank dash and cash. And so they're involved with that, and they're asking fans to participate. But what they also do, what you don't see, is what they're doing during the day, and mm-hmm. they're getting more involved in the individual departments, helping out with Adam Pohl, who's our voice now. We who is the radio voice for the Bay Sox, and helping out with our communications department, sales department, sponsorship department, doing all that. But they're also the ambassadors into the neighborhood. They're going.
So, what's the procedure for a youngster if he wants to get involved?
The way you want to do involved in that, as I mentioned, collegiate internship. We do reach out to high schools as well. Mm-hmm. Is during our off seasons, you want to send a resume in, let them know that we're looking to participate in this program, and it's a limited number of spots, and bring you in for an interview, and hopefully from there it works out. Other ways to get involved during the season is obviously we have game day opportunities, game day staff opportunities, mm-hmm. both concessions and in the operation side. Which operation side, you're talking about kids park, ticket takers, ushers,
right.
Working in concession stands. So mm-hmm. you have all those options to get involved. And the way that, to get involved in that, generally in March, late February, March, we'll have a game day hire fair, basically. Mm-hmm. And that's the way to get involved in that.
Yeah, and if organization or something that you have a special seating arrangement upstairs and upper deck, all of those, is the restaurant up there or is that for the public for just
that's the restaurant is always in use. It's first thing we say, always in use. Mm-hmm. Now there's a couple of different factors to that, and obviously our goal is to sell it to a company,
and
get them to spend, have a private catered event up there. Mm-hmm. But if it's not, it's open to the general public. Mm-hmm. As long as you have a box seat, reserve seat, or a ticket package, a flex pack, fielder's choice, any of those type of seats, you can go up and use the restaurant up there. And then that's always available on a Monday, Tuesday. Mm-hmm. And then if it's not sold Wednesday through Sunday when we have games, then that level takes in. Mm-hmm. But we're also going to have specific special events. We might have a build-in event like a beer dinner or wine dinner.
What about civic association churches having?
There's plenty of different packages to use it. It's not just a restaurant. There are the Potomac Room, the Chesapeake Room, the Owner Suite. There's those venues, and we have levels where you can purchase it with a two-hour buffet, or you can purchase it without food, or different levels of food. And the best way to do that is...
Well, that's what I was going to talk about. What about the promotion for food? Tell us about... You have quite a few of those.
Oh, we do. We have, Tuesdays is our Dollar Dog Days.
Yeah.
It's a great opportunity to come in and enjoy hot dogs and popcorn and at the game, and a pretty unique price. And we also have our Tuesday tailgates down in the Picnic Pavilion. A great opportunity down there. And then Sundays is Kids Eat Free Days, but you have to set up through the kids.
What was that? Kids
Kids Eat Free Days, but it's a special, you need to set it up through the kids club contact them to get that, because you got to get a special voucher.
But you, organization like the Girl Scouts, Boy Scouts, and things like that, they can actually reserve areas for special things.
Absolutely. Yeah, you know, we just actually had our Girl Scout lock-in, and you know, that was a great opportunity. And what we'll do is, you know, we'll lock them into the stadium, and they will, you know, we'll have certain sections set up in the stadium. You know, it could be a design section, a dance area.
But the thing I like is that when they have the sleepover, what tell them about that, where the kids go out and sleep on the field.
Under the stars, you know, that's a great opportunity.
Oh, that's what it's called.
Under the stars, it's a girl, well, that's what I like to call it. It's a Girl Scout sleepover, Boy Scout sleepover, and then in August, I want to say August 15th, is a family camp out. So,
you know, is that right? The whole family
families
can camp
that can't
out.
Do the, yeah, can't do these other days. We have it set up for that, and you get to go into the outfield after the game, after fireworks, and set up a tent, and we try not to have any food out on the field, but you know, we're not say no to it.
So you can see a lot of things happening out there.
Absolutely,
at Bay Sox Park there.
And Matt, as you were talking about the collegiate internship, I thought about a shadowing program. Like, you're the director of sponsorship. If a student was interested in sponsorship and sales, could they shadow you, like, for a day just to see what you do?
Yeah, we try to set that up, and that's a lot of where the you know, when you asked about the orange jerseys, that's a lot of what that collegiate program is.
Okay.
When you're not at the game, which is where the masses see everybody, you see, you know, we have them involved there. So they are shadowing us and learning the individual departments.
Hey, it's great. The Bay Sox are doing great there.
Absolutely.
They're over 500 and everything. Having you here, Matt, and we'll wish you another 10 years. But what we want is a championship out there.
So do we.
We want to go to a championship game, isn't that right? So, hey, look, this has been Ed Brown. See you next time. And don't forget to vote. Vote, vote, vote. Please. See you next time.